Hey guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. So today's video is a little bit different than the norm here on my channel. Today we aren't focusing on new products. I'm actually going to be doing a full face of absolutely nothing new. This video was really fun for me to film just because I got to sit down, do my makeup, and use the makeup that I wanted without having to worry about what's new, what I need to review. I just picked out some things from my collection that I feel like I haven't used as much as I would like to, and I put it on my face and I did it on camera for you guys. I did a really warm, pretty look for fall. I know a lot of you guys are on low buys or no buys or just want to go back and use the old products because we are so oversaturated with new products. So I do, of course, want to accommodate to you guys. So if you want to see some of the older products that I love and used in today's video, then just keep watching. So I didn't realize I would be uploading this on Thanksgiving, so I wanted to take a moment to wish you all a happy Thanksgiving, happy travels. I hope you guys get to eat a lot of good food, and I just wanted to take a second to tell you guys how thankful I am for you. Thank you so much for watching my videos and supporting me and commenting. It all really means so much to me. So it wouldn't feel right if I didn't get to personally wish you guys a happy Thanksgiving. So the primer that I put out for today's video is the Too Faced Hangover Replenishing Face Primers. I think this is one of the earlier primers that had come out, and it was very, very popular for quite some time, and I still love this. I haven't used it in a while because so many hydrating primers have come out since then that are great, but I recently started using this again just because it's getting colder outside and I can definitely feel my skin becoming a little bit more dry. So I've been using this again. It's pretty lotiony feeling, so I feel like I can feel it actually sinking into the skin. It's not super thin and silicone-y feeling. It has a little bit of grip to it, which I think is really great for foundation, and I actually feel like it moisturizes. So this is kind of an oldie but goodie product. I personally love it and I recommend it to everybody still to this day. So this one is still awesome. I still use it very often. The foundation that I picked out for today is the Laura Mercier Flawless Lumiere Radiance Perfecting Foundation. This was popular for quite some time. I haven't used it in a while because I got really tan this summer and this one is too light. This is 2N2. So let's see if it matches me. I really enjoy this foundation. I think it's really great for dry skin. It's really pretty and it wears a decent amount of time. It's just an overall very solid foundation, and for a while it was my favorite. I just haven't used it in a few months, but I think Laura Mercier has some really fantastic face products, and I'm happy to see them being used in videos and on social media because Laura Mercier can be an easily forgotten brand, but they really do put out quality products in my opinion. The pumper on this doesn't pump out that much product, I feel like, so I have to keep going in and pumping out more. Okay, so it has a more medium coverage, not super full coverage or anything, but it is a really pretty foundation that just feels super light on the skin. I'm gonna put a little bit of extra coverage right in the areas on my face that need it the most. By the way, yes, my Big Giant Real Techniques sponge is back. This is the face and body sponge, so it's really big because you're supposed to use it for the body, but I love it on the face too. I stopped and used a regular beauty blender for a while, but I pulled this one out and I'm really happy about it. So for eyebrows, I never really do anything super special for eyebrows. I think I'm just gonna play around with the ColourPop Brow Boss and then the Urban Decay Brow Blade. I'm gonna do this off camera because it takes way too much focus. And so eyebrows are done. Let's move on to concealer. For concealer, I chose the Makeup Forever Ultra HD Concealer. The catch on this was that it was self-setting, and honestly, Makeup Forever just paid a lot of influencers to sponsor their videos. So this concealer was talked about quite a lot and I do like it. I don't think it's the best concealer, but I do think it's a nice concealer. So I've been thinking about doing Shop My Stash-esque
videos for a while now, and this one is kind of starting it off, my first one, just kind of picking some older products that I simply felt like using. But if I do continue to do these styles of videos, if you guys like them, I'm thinking of doing kind of like themed Shop My Stash style videos like Michelle Wong just did, using only limited edition products. And I was just thinking in terms of maybe doing like products I've only used once, holiday 2018 makeup, just any kind of theme of me going back, digging through my collection and finding things to dig through that theme and putting them on my face. Let me know what you think about that, and if you have any suggestions, put them down below. Now, I can't guarantee I'll film these videos a ton, just because you guys know I do love reviewing on new releases. But honestly, I get so many comments about you guys being on no buys and wanting to go back to older stuff, so I definitely want to accommodate you guys as well. Also, it is fun to be able to go and use my collection, because that doesn't get to happen too often just because of the nature of my channel. So I would like to switch it up a little bit and sprinkle in some of these older product kind of videos for you guys. So now we're going to use the MAC and Patrick Star powder. So like, for example, if I were to do a holiday 2018 video, I would probably incorporate this as well. This powder created quite a buzz. I never really fell in love with this powder. I think it's a good powder. I don't know, to me, setting powders, I'm not too picky on them, just because I use very little to set very little areas on my face. So I'm not a big picky person when it comes to setting powders. I mean, I can tell a nice one from a bad one. And this one is for sure a nice one. My lips are so crusty right now. I apologize. Okay, so now I'm going to use my MAC Paint Pot as my eyeshadow base. My favorite brush to apply my paint pot is the Isom W25. I also use this brush to apply concealer on clients. It's seriously one of the best brushes, super versatile for cream products. There are so many different eyeshadow palettes that I could choose for this segment. It's probably the most exciting part. But after this, I'm finally filming my Viseart rankings video. So we're gonna play with a couple of my Viseart palettes. So I know I'm finally working on that video. I'm really excited. This is one of my newer ones, so I wanna work with this one. This is the warm mattes. So I'm gonna get my warm shades from here, and then I think I'm gonna get my shimmers from the Alcone palette with Viseart. This was a collaboration. So this palette is filled with amazing transition colors. So I'm gonna start off with this light creamy beige shade, and I'm just gonna kind of spread it out all along here. I think if you have a medium skin tone, this is great to set underneath the brow. I'm kind of trying to do this, but it might be a shade too dark for this step, but that's okay. And we are going to move in to this brown next. I'm not gonna do anything super crazy for this look today. I just wanna keep it simple. Obviously, I chose this for the brown shade. Even though this is a warm mattes palette, I really like that this isn't all like orange, red, and yellow shades. You just have some warm tone neutral shades that are super versatile as well. But that's why Viseart is great at what they do and why they have their reputation for professionals. They stick with the theme, but they also actually pick colors that make sense that will actually be used. And then we are going to spice it up with this shade right here. Just kind of throwing colors on my eyes, I feel like. Oof, that shade really holds its own. I feel like in a palette where the shadows aren't as great quality, this shade would kind of dust away and be invisible on this kind of look. And this brush is so versatile. This is the Wayne Goss number 18. You can pack and blend with this brush. It's awesome. I'm going to add some depth and mix these two shades. This right here, slowly work that in. I just feel like with my schedule, I don't get to play with my collection as much as I would like. So if I were to periodically film videos like these, it would be so awesome just to have a real reason to dig into my older makeup instead of having to constantly be using new releases for my reviews and videos. And as you can see, I'm really adding the depth, and you can see how freaking amazing these shadows are blending. It's honestly just unreal. So I did make it a little bit more smoky just because I am filming a couple of videos, so I do want my makeup to stand out a little bit. So now we're done with warm mattes. So I'm going to play with this orange shade right here, and then I'm gonna put gold in the inner part. I haven't used this particular palette, the Alcone palette, too terribly much, as much as I hate to admit that, but I really just like the palette itself and how it looks. Then of course you are getting a really nice formula with them too. What I didn't like about this palette is that there are just repeat shades from other palettes, and if you're crazy like me and own all of their palettes, but the curation of this palette was too pretty for me to pass up on. I'm gonna dig into that gold shade that I showed you. So these shades would look incredible if you use them wet. I think in some palettes where Viseart lacks is their shimmer formula, if I'm being honest. In some palettes, I think their shimmer formula is incredible. And then in other palettes, I think they're just okay. So it is kind of dependent on the palette, how their shimmers work. I would say the shimmers in this palette are their average formula, but they're not bad. But they're still just like super good though. And I'm going to take this light shade right here and we're gonna highlight the inner corner with that. Boom. Oof, that's stunning. Oh my goodness. This look, by the way, is so good for Thanksgiving. So for bronzer, I'm actually going to be using a drugstore item. This is the Maybelline City Bronzer. This is such a good bronzer. The drugstore has some really nice bronzers that I enjoy. I do actually get asked a lot about bronzers. Some people seem to be, from what I can tell, you're very picky with the bronzer that you like and what matches your undertone, which is completely fine. I'm going to be honest, for me, I'm not really picky when it comes to bronzer, as long as it's not splotchy and it blends out, chances are I'll probably like it. I just think there's a lot of great bronzers out there, and the undertones do give a different look to the face and a different dimension. This one I would say is a little bit more cool toned, so it does a good job of kind of deepening the areas and giving you a little bit of sculpt. It's not super warm. So this one is 200, which I like. If you're very fair, I also like the 100 a lot for days that I want a less chiseled look and more just dimension. Love that one, but this is a really great bronzer from the drugstore. So for blush, I picked out a palette that I'm surprised I like as much as I do, and this is the Morphe blush palette. I'm just very attracted to the way that it looks, and I can't lie, it's a decent blush palette. I think the quality in here is really nice, and I haven't used this in a while just because I have so many other blushes that I like more than this, but this one isn't bad. I thought I would give it some love. So I'm gonna go into Provocative, and then I'm going to take a little bit of Beat on top to add extra sheen to the look. But yeah, if you go in with a really light hand, that shade is not as intimidating as it looks, and I think this blush in particular will look really nice on deeper skin tone. But see how I just used a little touch of it on the cheek and it doesn't look as intimidating at all? Really pretty. And now I'm gonna go into Beat that shimmer just to add a little bit of fun to the face. This is, by the way, the Warm blush palette, and it is really nice. If you're on a budget and you want some range in your blushes, I definitely would recommend looking into this one. It's good. I like it. Now for highlight, I chose something that I wanted to kind of take a second go around for, and this is the Natasha Denona Glow Gold Duo. Now this is actually on sale for Black Friday, so I would definitely recommend picking this up if you've been wanting it. But in my initial review of it, I wasn't that crazy about it, so I wanted to try it again because I haven't tried it again since. So I'm starting off here, and if I recall, yeah. Just a bit glittery. I was going to return it and then just time passed and it never happened. Yeah, I mean, I still definitely think it's a bit glittery for my taste. It applied more glitter than it did glow. So I'm gonna go into this one, which is a bit dark for my skin tone, but it's doable. I still don't really love this. Let me take that light shade. We're just gonna add a little bit of gleam to the eyes. Yeah, this is just better on the eyes for me personally. So if you don't like glitter, you're not gonna like this highlight. I think it'd be really neat on a deeper skin tone though, but you still have to like glitter. Just for a little actual glow to my face, I'm using the Wet n Wild Highlighting Gold Bar. This was just a really hot item back in the day, but it is super pretty. I don't know. See, now I'm having problems for any blush shed here. I'm just gonna do that to add an additional kind of glow to the face. This is like a really cool $4 highlighter if you can grab it at your stores. It's really good. Okay, So I'm going to do liner, lashes, and all of that good stuff. Nothing that's really worth seeing, and I'll be back for the lips. Okay, so of course, liner and lashes made the biggest difference. So I used the ColourPop Liquid Liner in Grande, which is just a brown liquid liner. And then I used my lashes in a box, which you can get from Muse Beauty Pro in the style number 28. And these are basically like Ardell Demi Wispies. Lips. Grab some random things that I felt like using. So I'm gonna use my MAC lip pencil in Cork. To this day, MAC has one of my favorite lip liner formulas. They're waxy. And I like a good soft lip liner formula, but I feel like waxy lip liners actually do their job as a lip liner, and they really stop that lipstick from going outside the lines. And then over top, I'm using a Morphe color in the shade Boo, because it's like a really neutral peachy brown. So this shade without that round liner would have gone horribly wrong. With the Cork, I love it. I do want a little extra shine. So I'm using one of my most used lip glosses. This is from Jeffree Star. It's Legends Only. I just love this color. It's a very neutral color. I mean, honestly, it's almost clear. I don't know. For some reason, I really, really love this gloss. I love the formula. I love the packaging. I do always need to wipe it off, though, before I put it back in so it doesn't mix colors. And then boom, here is the final look. I mean, I feel like this video didn't have too much of a point. I kind of just wanted to put on makeup and put on the makeup that I wanted to put on, not have to worry about what's new or not have to worry about reviewing it for you guys and really taking in the formula, just using what I wanted to use and doing it on camera for you guys. So let me know if you liked this style of video. I know it's nothing super exciting, but I find videos like these using older products a bit relaxing, and filming it was super relaxing, just putting on the stuff. Everything I used, I really, really liked, except for the highlighter. Other than that, I'm very happy with how this look turned out. It's perfect for Thanksgiving. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you found it helpful. Let me know some older products that you would like to see me use on camera, and I definitely will. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys, have a good one.